Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
He shall tell them all that I command him.
joyfully to the Lord. Let us acclaim the rock of our salvation. Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving. Let us joyfully sing sorrows to him.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the God who made us. For he is our God, and we are the people he shepherds, the flock he guides.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Oh, that today you would hear his voice. Harden not your hearts as at Meribah, as in the day of Massa in the desert, where your fathers tested me. They tested me, though they had seen my works.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I should like you to be free of anxieties. An unmarried man is anxious about the things of the Lord, how he can may please the Lord. But a married man is anxious about the things of the world, how he may please his wife, and he is divided. An unmarried
His fame spread everywhere throughout the whole region of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I presume that most of us have heard this saying in English, practice what you preach. Normally, if we invoke this saying or this proverb, we're doing it against those who we think are not practicing what they preach. People who may say one thing and do another. Individuals we would consider to be hypocrites. Just as our Lord had accused the scribes and Pharisees of being hypocrites. However, this saying, practice what you preach, is also a good way for understanding today's gospel. A gospel that focuses on the authority that Jesus had. The gospel began saying that on the Sabbath, Jesus entered the synagogue and taught. What our Lord did would have been something normal that others would have done as well. They gathered in the synagogue on the Sabbath. Then someone would read from one of the scrolls, the Word of God, our Old Testament, and then expound on what was read, teach based on the Word of God that had been read. What Jesus did in that sense would have been no different from anyone else. But today's gospel notes the reaction of the people, which was different. When Jesus, on that Sabbath, went into the synagogue and taught. The gospel says, right after noting that Jesus taught, that the people were astonished at his teaching. It says that he taught as one having authority. So the gospel tells us that what people were most impressed with was the authority Jesus taught, the authority which he seemed to possess and convey in that moment. The gospel does not tell us what Jesus taught. It does not indicate what he said or what the particular teachings were that he conveyed to the people on that day. The gospel gives importance to the reaction of the people, saying they were astonished that he taught as one with authority and not as the scribes. That is, he taught different from the other religious leaders like the scribes. And it was the reaction of the people that the gospel is taking note of. That Jesus, in teaching, conveyed authority. And then it goes on and says, in their synagogue was a man with an unclean spirit. And Jesus goes and expels the unclean spirit from the man. The gospel does not tell us how the man himself reacted to being free from the unclean spirit. Instead, once again, the gospel focuses on the reaction of the people present. It says, all were amazed and asked one another, what is this? A new teaching with authority. It is not clear why the people saw this expulsion of the demon as a teaching, but their reaction was clear. They saw it once again as Jesus exercising authority. In expelling the demon, Jesus once again conveyed authority. In the eyes of the people, the authority our Lord had was not just found in his words, but also in his deeds. Generally speaking, for us today, someone with authority is someone who has power or influence. A person can have authority because of the position that gives them a certain amount of right to do certain things or the right to decide certain things. Or we might consider someone in authority on a certain subject. And therefore, what they say would be given special credence or acceptance. They would exercise an influence because they're considered to be an authority on a certain matter. The gospel, today's gospel, tells us that Jesus' authority came from both what he said and what he did. He taught in the synagogue, expounding on the scripture. He expelled an unclean spirit from a possessed man. And he did both of these things with authority, with a sense of power that came from within him. It was an authority based on who he was. An authority that came from Jesus living a coherent life. An inner authority from someone who practiced what he preached. Jesus was consistent in what he said and in what he did. And that was evident to the people. For that reason, they saw him as teaching with authority. And he taught the people both in word and in deed, in what he said and what he did in their midst. And for this reason, the people saw him as different from their own religious leaders. So what does this gospel and the authority of Jesus in practicing what you preach say to us today as his disciples? If we want people to listen to what we say as church, we need to practice what we preach. I suppose each one of us could be accused of being a hypocrite. Each one of us accused of not practicing what we preach. And in one sense, that would be true. Because what we preach is Jesus Christ. And of course, each one of us in our own ways will fall short of him. But what truly matters is that we strive to put into practice the faith we hold and profess. We strive to live a life in keeping with our faith, in keeping what Jesus taught and in what Jesus himself did. And when we do make that effort to put our practice of faith into our everyday daily life, then the presence of the Holy Spirit and the power God's grace comes forth from within us. And we become witnesses to the authority of Christ in our lives, in both word and deed. Let us profess together our faith. I believe
in one God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten of God, consubstantial with the Father.
Jesus taught with authority in both word and deed. Through him, let us pray to our Heavenly Father with confidence.
For our church, that she may continue to teach the truth of Christ with authority, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, your glory be in our prayer.
For world leaders,
transform them into the sacrament of our redemption, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to our fallen state, and by his suffering he canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Together with Francis, our Pope,
Cardinal Stephen, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. With confidence, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Thank you. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ keep us safe for life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
We would like to bring to your attention the following church announcements. As we soon begin our Lenten season, all those who have blessed formal branches from the past year are asked to bring them to the parish to be burned for the making of ashes for Ash Wednesday. You can leave the old blessed palms at the parish counter, or at the latest, bring them to Midsunday's Mass, where they will be collected. Our Ash Wednesday Mass in English and distribution of ashes will take place on 14 February at 7:30 p.m. in the parish hall. Thank you for your attention. May God bless you all.
True faith may ever increase. We ask this.